بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد. وعلى أهل بيت الأطهار الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. قال الله الحكيم في محكم كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر، ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر، تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام، سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Inshallah, this year will be the year of the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi Ajalallah Ta'ala Faraju Sharif with the blessing of another loud salawat. Inshallah, all of us gathering tonight will be amongst his companions and his sincere soldiers with the blessing of another loud salawat. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وأبدلني من بغضة أهل الشنآن المحبة ومن حسد أهل البغي المودة. O Allah, send your peace and blessing upon Muhammad and his progeny, and replace for me the animosity of the people of hatred with love, and the envy of the people of insolence with affection. Another segment of Dua Makarim al-Akhlaq by our fourth Imam, Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Which addresses a very, very crucial and important discussion and topic that we are in mind, it is in our mind on a daily basis, and we try to do whatever it is possible to have these two concepts in our life from people toward us. And they are the concepts of love and hate, which we really care. We care about people loving us, and we hate people hating us. We do whatever it's possible for people not to hate us and not to have hatred coming toward us. To some extent, we are successful, and to some extent, we are not. We have within our life and people that surround us, there are some people that no matter what we do, they still hate us. Either, number one, because of what we do, that they hate us, and we're doing something bad. I as a husband, I as a wife, I'm doing something that my wife or my husband hates me. Or we have other people, because of wrongdoing, wrong action that I'm taking, people hate us. That's number one, which we have to change. Number two, there are people that because who we are and the status that we have got, they hate us, which we cannot do anything about it. Should we let it go? Should we have people who hate us not because of the action that we are taking? If you remember in previous nights, we did talk about a very important concept that if somebody treats you bad, if somebody wrongs you, how should you pay them back, and the four levels. And we said in Quran that Quran and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pushes us toward this direction that اتفع بالتي هي أحسن, repel with what is the best. But the love and hate exist. Do these concepts have a place in our religion? Of course. When we look at the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, they tell us one of the hadith, هل الدين إلا الحب والبغض? Isn't it that deen is all about love and hate? When we say that Religion is religion of love and hate. We have to come and to the teachings of it, that who should we love? What are the bases that we have to love or hate someone? Should we hate a person or should we hate the action? Which is very, very important. When we criticize, do we criticize the person himself or we criticize his action? Inshallah, within the end of lecture, we will come to conclusion. Who should we hate? Why should we hate? Who should we love? Why should we love? What are the bases for these loves and hates? قال الباقر عليه السلام He narrates from Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, which Rasulullah narrates, ود المؤمن للمؤمن في الله من أعظم شعب الإيمان. Love and the passion that a believer has for a believer, من أعظم, is amongst the greatest branch of Iman. We talked about the first night or two. Allahumma balligh bi'imani akmal al-iman. Oh Allah, take my iman to the most complete level of iman. Imam says that love of a mu'min for mu'min fillah. So that becomes number one criteria. Why we love people? Do we love them because of their belongings? Do we love them because of their beauties, their outer beauties, be it the same sex or opposite sex? Why do we love who we love? Imam says, you should love, and that love should be the criteria and the base should be وَالْوَدُّ الْمُؤْمَنَ لِلْمُؤْمَنِ فِي اللَّهِ, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مِنْ أَعْظَمِ شُعَبِ الْإِيمَانِ, it is amongst the best and the greatest branch of Iman. Allah, indeed. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ فِي اللَّهِ, the one who loves because of Allah. This person is close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I love him because of Allah. أَلَا وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ فِي اللَّهِ, number one. وَأَبْغَضَ فِي اللَّهِ, and he hates because of Allah. وَأَعْطَى فِي اللَّهِ, and he gives because of Allah. وَمَنَعَ فِي اللَّهِ, and he discouraged because of Allah. فَهُوَ مِنْ أَصْفِيَاءِ اللَّهِ, he is amongst those people who are chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to be Allah's chosen one. My name is Mustafa. Mustafa means the chosen one, which is the name, another name of Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. We like to be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any other being that you love to be chosen by, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we want to be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to love because of Allah, hate because of Allah, give because of Allah, then we will be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alaykum as-salam. Because it's no longer me. Allah loves this person, I love him. Allah hates this person because of what he has done, I hate him. Allah says in Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَيُؤْذُونَ الرَّسُولَ, those who hurt Allah and hurt Rasulullah. Rasulullah, Allah says, whoever satisfies, oh Allah, we want to see who you love, what satisfies you. On earth, is there any being that their satisfaction becomes your satisfaction and their anger becomes your anger? So we know the scale. Allah says via the mouth of Rasulullah, إِنَّ اللَّهِ يَرْضَى لِرِضَى فَاطِمَةِ وَيَغْضَبُ لِغَضَبِ فَاطِمَةِ. Let's have salawat by her name. So Fatima al-Zahra, salamullah alayha, she becomes the scale. Anyone who hurts Fatima al-Zahra, anyone who angers Fatima al-Zahra, angers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever makes, satisfies her, satisfies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me look, forget about people in history. We know who angered Fatima al-Zahra and what they did to Fatima al-Zahra. It's clear evidence in history. Nobody can deny it. When people come and they try to deny, I say we can deny the interpretation, can give different meaning. And I give them this example. If 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now, people are reading the history and they want to come and negate September 11, that September 11 did not happen, can they come and agree and argue that September 11 didn't happen? Of course not, because thousands and thousands of people saw it, they wrote it, it is in history. They can come and argue who did it, why did it, how did it, when did it, how did it happen, what was behind it. Those are up to interpretation. But the event itself, it has happened. But let me look at my life, my personality, my characteristic. Does it satisfy Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha or not? I as a brother, I as a sister, Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha is not only a role model for sisters. No. Hujjatullah fil ard. Our current Imam Mahdi ajalallah ta'ala farajhu sharif. Imam Zaman Adilallah Ta'ala Farajul Sharif, he says a beautiful narration that in the daughter of Rasulullah, for me, Hujjatullah, I as a believer man, in her I find a role model. So if Fatima al-Zahra Salamullah Alayha is a role model for Imam Zamana, isn't she a role model for us also? So whatever satisfies her, I should do. Does my hijab satisfy Fatima al-Zahra? Yes or not? My personality, does it satisfy Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha or not? My relationship with people, does it satisfy Fatima al-Zahra or not? Let's continue. So we love by Allah, hate by Allah. Because of Allah, we love and hate. So how should we know that this good is in us, loving for Allah and hating for Allah? Let's go to another hadith by Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. إذا أردت أن تعلم أن فيك خيرا. If you want to know, if I want to know that in me there is something good or not, I want to test myself. Is there good in me or not? إذا أردت أن تعلم أن فيك خيرا فانظر إلى قلبك. Look at your heart. فإن كان يحب أهل طاعة الله ويبغض أهل معصيته ففيك خيرا والله يحبك. If you love people who are, they show obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're geared toward people who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you gear toward people who are religious, you like to associate yourself with the people who go to Dua Kumail every Thursday night, you like to befriend those people who remind you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you gear toward a person who tells you this is right, halal, and this is haram. فَإِنْ كَانَ يُحِبُّ أَهْلَ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. Those people who are in obedience of Allah. وَيُبْغِضُ أَهْلَ مَعْصِيَتِهِ. And hates those people who always show you the path towards sin. One sin is no problem. Your hijab, it's loose, no problem. You delayed your salah right now. Let's watch this game. Let this game between two basketball teams, it's happening. Let the game finish. Delaying. I might be at work and there's an emergency. I'm doing something. Okay, there is a time for me. I can push it a little bit back. But watching entertainment. So if I have to see within me, who do I love and who do I hate? And that love and hate comes based on my personality. Who I hang with? Who are my people? فَإِنْ كَانَ يُحِبُّ أَهْلَ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ وَيُبْغِضُ أَهْلَ مَعْصِيَتِهِ. Those who commit sin, فَفِيكَ خَيْرٍ. It's good in you. There is something good in you. Take advantage of this goodness. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّكَ. And Allah loves you. Who else Allah loves? We're trying to get to the dua, to the segment that Imam says, "Oh Allah, replace for me the animosity of the people of hatred with love." They have animosity toward me. People of hatred, replace it with love. We have to see first, are we a lover or are we a hater? Are we considered to be people of hate or people of love? Who does Allah love? Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 222. Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabina wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. And Allah, indeed, Allah loves those who are constantly repentant and love those who are purify themselves. Tawwabin. So if Allah loves those who are tawwabin, who repent, shouldn't we love those people who repent? I know a person who is committing a sin. I know my own wife, she commits sin. She's a bad human being. She comes and says forgiveness, or vice versa. I know my husband, he's a sinful person. Please recite aloud salawat and move forward. Everybody, please come as much as possible forward, because people come and they see there's no space, they just close the door and they leave. Let's have another loud salawat. My spouse has a sin. And they come and say, Astaghfirullah Rabbi wa atubu ilayhi, and they ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Should I forgive them or not? Allah loves those people who repent. Why should not give them a chance, another chance? If Allah gives a chance and chance and chance and a chance. A father came to me and he had a very beautiful concept. He said, I told him, like, you forgive your son a lot. You always forgive him. He does something wrong, you forgive him. He does something wrong, you forgive him. Again and again and again. He told me, Sheikh, isn't this the relationship that we have with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Oh Allah, sorry, astaghfirullah, rabbi wa tubuli. I go and sin again. I come back again. Oh Allah, I'm sorry. I come back again and I say for forgiveness. And I keep committing sin and I come back and I ask for forgiveness. Allah says, even if you came and knocked on my door 1,000 times, come back and 1,001, the door is still open. It's a great sin to lose hope in Allah's forgiveness. We are not promoting that, okay, let's go commit sin, we ask forgiveness. Let's go commit sin and we ask forgiveness. No. Because again, as we said in the previous night, we might be committing sin, and during the time of sin, Allah takes our soul and we don't have the time for repentance. And sometimes it might take the tawfiq and the blessing of asking from repentance, like people who have created hate and animosity in our nation. But if we committed sin, not purposely, I'm committing sin and I'm going to ask forgiveness. No. Shaitan comes and deviates us, and our nafs sometimes overtake us. We commit sin. Allah says the door of repentance is open for you. No matter how many times you ask repentance, still come back. Why? Because imagine if you lose hope in Allah's mercy, that Allah will forgive you. Well, I already committed 10 sins. Allah is not going to forgive me. Let me just continue. Since He's not forgiving me, since I'm already in hellfire, at least let me enjoy this dunya, because in hereafter it's going to be hellfire. Let me enjoy. Allah says, no, the door of repentance is always open. And we see that within the life of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Allah, is it possible for that mercy of yours to be applied on earth? Of course. Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, they are the manifestation of Allah's attribute on earth. Imam Ali alayhi salam gets to the bed of Umar al-Khattab, and he says, Umar is on his last day. Imam tell him, have you repented of what you have done to Fatima al-Zahra? He said, yes, what I did was wrong, because they came also, they asked, they wanted to talk with Fatima al-Zahra and repent and ask for forgiveness. He said, are you ashamed of what you have done? He said, yes. He said, okay, I will guarantee heaven for you. I will guarantee forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you. Just come, go on top of the member and say to people, what I have done was wrong. It's wrong. Another chance. Isn't it given? The door of repentance is not closed. Come. I will guarantee. I, Ali ibn Abi Talib, and what you have done to my wife, I'll take care of it between me and Allah. He had a blanket. He puts it on his head. He says, Al-nar wal-al-ar. I rather go to hellfire, but not to be ashamed in front of a people. Repentance. The door of repentance is open. So if Allah is forgiving my sin every day and He gives me, my son makes a mistake. I, that I am knowledgeable person, I use my brain, I make mistakes, I commit sin. Well, there are kids. No, you did this. No more forgiveness. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَحِّرِينَ. Allah gives us chance. Let us give one another also chance. Whatever we have done, we cannot become worse than him, killing Fatima to Zahra. We cannot become worse than Yazid, which he comes to Imam Zain al-Abidin. Is there any door for me to repent? Imam says, pray Salat al-Ghufayr. There is a chance for you. You will not be able, you don't have that blessing amongst, but Allah keeps the door open for us. Going back to the love and hate. قال الصادق عليه السلام similar to the hadith that we read, من أحب لله, whoever loves for Allah, وأبغض لله, وأعطى لله, فهو ممن كمل إيمانه. We want complete iman. Imam says, love for Allah, hate for Allah, and give for Allah, you will be amongst those people who your iman is completed. Who we have to ask for this? So we should not let people hate us. Number one, our action should not be in a way to make people hate us. And do whatever it is which is haq. When it comes to haq and batil, we do what is haq, let the whole world hate us. We do haq. Rasulullah told his companions, if you see Ali ibn Abi Talib going on the right and the whole universe going left, you go with Ali. That's it. We do what is haq in the best of manners. People, their perception about changes, let their perception change. We have to do, next step that we have to do dua. It is in Allah's hand to change people's heart. We can't do it. We cannot change people's hearts. Quran, Surah Al-Anfal, chapter 8, verse 63. وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. Beautiful verse. And he has brought together their hearts. If you had spent all that is in the earth, you could not have brought their hearts together. Allah does it. Don't we have stories within Quran? Prophet Musa ala nabina wa alayhi salam, Pharaoh tells his people, kill any kid, any woman, it's pregnant, kill. They have a boy, kill it. Because he knows there will be a Musa coming. Kill. Allah, a baby comes in a basket and the river, they opened it. Asiya sees, the love gets into her heart, and also Pharaoh, who says kill every boy, he raises Prophet Musa in his own palace. If Allah wants to play with the hearts, he can. Pharaoh raises Musa in his own palace, which he's already ordering people, and probably during the time that Prophet Musa was still a day or two or three or week or two, still they were killing boys of Bani Israel outside. And he had Musa in his palace and he was in love with that son, with that little baby Prophet Musa. Is it possible? Yes. Who should we ask? Oh Allah, replace the animosity of the people of hatred with love. Not correct their animosity. No, replace it. Replace meaning what? You take something and you put something else. We have two Quran here right now. I'm going to replace this Quran with this Quran. It's on the top and this is on the bottom. There is no more red Quran here. I'm replacing. Oh Allah, the animosity of the people of hatred that is toward me, you replace it with love. No matter what I do, it's not going to work. I have to be good. But always, as we said, there are two reasons that people hate us. Either because of bad act that we have to change, or because of the status that we have within a community, people hate us. Love and hate, very important concept, which our deen, again, is love and hate. Action plan. People that are surrounding me, that I love them, or I don't associate with them. Why do I don't associate with them? Or why do I associate with them? Families that we are close. Why do I love them? Why do I love my wife? Is it because she's doing something for me? No, because I love her. Imam Ali alayhi salam was asked by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Rasulullah asked Imam Ali and Fatima al-Zahra the same question, different time. How did you find your spouse? He asked Imam Ali about Fatima al-Zahra, and he asked Fatima al-Zahra about Imam Ali. How did you find your spouse? Look at the beautiful answer. نِعْمَ الْعَوْنَ عَلَىٰ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. They are the best aid that he is or she is the best aid. For what? Best aid in cooking food for me? No. Best aid for my relationship? No. Best aid in cleaning the house? No. Best aid for the best akhlaq? No. Best aid in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This spouse of mine, Imam Ali saying about Fatima al-Zahra, and Fatima al-Zahra about Imam Ali alayhi salam, that my spouse is the best aid that I have in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to become friends. Why do we want to become friends? That relationship, friendship, which is very, very good and is a necessity. I don't have a time, but inshallah, if I get a chance, one day to talk about the importance of having a friend. It's not an option. It's a must to have a good friend. It's not an option. We cannot find a good friend to let it go. No, we have to go and seek for a good friend. It's a must for a purpose. Then inshallah, if we get a chance, we'll talk. Why do we get people... We start having a love relationship with the opposite sex or establishing a friendship, brothers and brothers and sisters. Why? So we can help one another. Fillah. This relationship, this love relationship, it's to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How does that change our personality in finding our future spouse? Will my future spouse help me toward getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or by the time, as soon as I get to my spouse, haram starts. I was religious 10 degrees. When she got with me or he got with me, I became completely non-religious. That is not right criteria to look. That is why, and as I told our younger generation in Q&A, Rasulullah said two criteria, if it's in the boy that comes to ask for your daughter's hand, give them your daughter. Two criteria. How many? Father calls me, Sheikh, my son has 2 degrees. He has job, career, he has a house, and he has a wife. Can you find him a girl? I ask him what Rasulullah said. What is his religiosity and what is his akhlaq? Rasulullah says, if a boy comes to you and he has good akhlaq and he's religious, give him your daughter. But when we sit and the poor guy sits in front of us, the interrogation starts. How many degrees do you have? What is your GPA? What is your credit score? What is your credit line? The house that you have, how many square footage? The car that you have, is it 2016 or not? Because that's the standard of my girl. Akhlaq? Religion, inshallah, they are religion, inshallah. They're akhlaq. Why don't we say, inshallah, they will have money. They will have a degree. Why we don't say that? So from tonight, our criteria for starting a relationship with people will be for Allah, hate for Allah, give for Allah, and oh Allah, please, I beg you, oh Allah, replace for me the animosity of the people of hatred with love. There are people who hate me. Why we ask that? Why? Because people who hate can cause us harm and damage. Story, and I finish. I know I have gone over my time. There was an individual who was on his deathbed. He tells his son, go grab me four of my friends, Mr. Fulan and Fulan and Fulan and Fulan. Bring them here. He brings them. The person who's in the deathbed, he tells them, please forgive me. I have done so much bad to you. They say, no, you haven't done anything bad to us. No, I have done it. Please forgive me. One of them insists, I want to really know what you have done to me. He said, no, please forgive me. He says, no, I want to know. In order for me to forgive you, I have to know what you have done so I can forgive you. Please, let's not get on that route. If somebody comes, tells you, sorry, I apologize, I have gossiped behind your back. No, tell me what you have said behind my back. Tell me. I'm not going to forgive. They're there asking for forgiveness. Just forgive them. Say, inshallah, khair, may Allah forgive you, forgive both of our sins. He insisted. He said, one day I hated you because of your belongings. You had a farm. You had this. You had this. You had this. I hated you. I wanted to cause some harm, which will be, inshallah, talk of tomorrow, envy and jealousy and what it can lead to. I hated you, and I didn't know what to do. One day, I was walking by your farm. I heard you and someone else fighting. He told you, he threatened you that tomorrow I'm going to burn your farm. And he left. I heard it. I came at night, and I burned your farm. Everybody thought that it was him. He is in prison because of me. That hate that I had towards you pushed me toward come and harming you and harming your farm. It wasn't that person. It was me who did it. And I really asking for forgiveness. So when this dua teaches us, oh Allah, ask, there is a reason why Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam is saying this. Oh Allah, replace for me the animosity of the people of hatred with love. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma ajjal li waliyyika al-faraj. Allahumma ajjal li waliyyika al-faraj. Allahumma ajjal li waliyyika al-faraj. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allahumma kun li waliyyika al-hujjat ibn al-Hasan. صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا صلوات